Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's take a look at the print function inside the calendar app on your Mac. It's actually useful for a lot more things than you may think. So in El Capitan, the calendar app has some pretty interesting printing functions, but you may never have thought to even look there. Let's take a look and see what it can do. If you go to File, Print, you see it comes up with, well, it looks like a decently printed calendar here that you can go ahead and print out this month and will include your events. You can see them in there in the preview. You can also customize it a lot, like for instance, whether or not to include all day events or events with a specific time or neither or both. The mini calendars here at the top, the keys which basically show which calendars you're including, and by the way you can choose which calendars you want to include. So for instance if you want to turn off certain calendars then they won't appear here and the events won't appear in there. You can also switch to black and white to save on printing ink, and you can change the text size. So for instance you can have the text in here appear bigger. You also get to choose the range. So you can do say this month or next month or say starts in January and ends in December. And now I'm going to have 12 months to be printed. So I'm actually going to print an entire calendar here. In this case it may actually be useful to turn off all the events and have a blank calendar printed out. It's a cheat way to get a calendar. But you can choose other things here as well. And you'll see that in a second as we change the view. So when you change the view it's a pretty dramatic change. You've got day, week, month, and list. So let's look at day. And in day here you get this kind of day planner view. And you can set similar things here like which calendars and what appears and what doesn't, and it gives you an idea of your day. You can change which date is there, and you can also have it go to specific days. So I can actually have multiple days included as well, and you can see it's going to print 5 days here. I can change to week to get a week view, and you can see the events in there. One of the most interesting ones though is to change to list. List will actually give you a list of events over a range. So I can start today and go for as many days as I want, and you can see all the different days appear here and then any events appear underneath them. And I can also customize what it looks like, for instance by changing some of these things and the font size and all of that. But the cool thing about the list view is it's the only way I know of to get a list of all of your different events. You can't export them from the calendar. You can't get them any other way. But here if I were to do this and say continue and then just say just open that in preview, don't actually print it, I get this list here. I can select text and copy and paste it into something. So say if I wanted to give to a colleague my schedule for the next 10 days say, I could actually print a list view here and then copy and paste this into an email, and then they would see what I've got in kind of a list form. It helps if you edit this because you see you get these days here that have no entry and lots of those. So you can go in really quickly and just delete some of those days and just leave the days that actually have something going on, and it's a quick way to kind of export into a list the things that you've got in your calendar. Now here's an even better way to do this. You can select various events using the command key here so they don't have to be continuous, or you could just select all, command A, and you select all the visible events. And then when you go to print you can choose the view of selected events, and it doesn't include the days where there's nothing or where you haven't selected something. So this is an even better way to get a list of events that you've got coming up or appointments and possibly give them to somebody else. You can get rid of some of the stuff up here to make it really short and just basically use this as a PDF here, or copy there and then let's say let's open this up in text edit, but say this could be an email I was composing. And you can see it's a pretty neat view here. I can maybe add some spaces to make it even better. And now this is something I could send to somebody to then give them my schedule or even to print out for myself as a schedule of what I've got coming up. So another useful way to use printing without actually even using any paper. So I love functions like this, like print here, and when there's so many different options, because I'm sure that if you play around with it long enough you'll find some really interesting things that you can do with this by selecting different options and different views, even different sets of paper and all sorts of things with ranges. So I encourage you to play around with this, experiment, and see what else you can come up with to make use of the print function. It doesn't necessarily involve just printing.